Okay, now let's go over to Maguindanao. Maguindanao Provincial Administrator Cyrus Torreña, still on the recently concluded plebiscite. Good morning to you, sir.
Yes, good morning, Ma'am Karen. Good morning po sa ating lahat, lalong-lalo na sa aming mga constituents dito sa province of Maguindanao. Assalamu alaikum.
All right, now where are you exactly? Are you now in Del Norte or Del Sur? Where is your office?
I am in Maguindanao, Del Sur.
Okay.
It's in Puluan, that is the seat of the government of the undivided Maguindanao and will become the seat of the Maguindanao del Sur.
All right. How significant is this for Maguindanao that now you're divided into two provinces in terms really of making a difference in the lives of your constituents and the residents of Maguindanao?
The delivery of basic services will definitely be better this time. As of now, when we are still under the undivided Maguindanao, it's so difficult to deliver the basic services of our constituents, considering that there are 36 municipalities in the province of Maguindanao. Mm-hmm. From end to end of Maguindanao, you need to travel not less than 5 hours. That's how difficult to deliver the necessary services for our people here in Maguindanao. Aside from that, there's another area. It's an island that you need to travel even by boat in just to deliver the necessary basic services. With the division of Maguindanao into Maguindanao del Norte and Maguindanao del Sur, the delivery will become better as the local government will become nearer to the people of Maguindanao.
Okay. Now, between the two provinces, which of them need more investments? I mean, of course, Maguindanao del Sur and del Norte would appreciate both. But for example, with the splitting into two, the basic question is, where did the biggest hospital land in? Did it land in del Norte or del Sur?
There is no hospital to talk with in our province in Maguindanao. The provincial health office, the health services is not a devolved function for Maguindanao. It is with the BARM. Technically, we do not have our provincial health officer. We do not have our own provincial social welfare and development officer. But with the coming of RA 11550,
yes,
we are now mandated to create our own PHO and our own PSWDO.
Yeah, very good. That was quite surprising, that something like health and social welfare, you don't have presence of that specifically in the province. So that would be very difficult in terms of emergencies as well.
Yes, it's so difficult, uh-oh, but we are doing our own, in our own little way, despite the fact that the delivery of basic services, including the health services, is with the BARM. It's under the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao.
Yeah.
That's a part of their function.
Okay. Now, I'm curious. I spoke with Rex just now. The municipalities, the number of mayors won't change because it was just basically split. But yes, the provincial government, you'll have additional, and yung provincial board, right? I wasn't able to ask about Congress. You'll still be having the same number of congressmen.
The same number, one for Maguindanao del Sur and one for Maguindanao del Norte. Technically, we are divided based also on the legislative districting.
Mm-mm. Okay. Now, in terms of the funding, of course, the drafting of the budget will now be different that you have two provinces. Let's talk about the current budget today that really goes into Maguindanao and what kind of change or increase are you seeing?
As of now, our budget is more or less 3 billion only, and we will be dividing that based on the guidelines of the Department of Budget and Management. We have not yet received the guidelines as how are we going to divide the 3 billion budget for the next year operation of the two provinces.
Oh, and if you have to add more staffing in terms of provincial, no? Because now you're two. Would you say then that you can't split it to 1.5, 1.5, right?
Technically, yes, including our loans, we will be divided into two.
What happens to that? What happens to the loans?
We are still negotiating as regards the loan. We are still in the process of discussing the matter with the Land Bank of the Philippines. How are we going to pay for the loan? Because technically, based on 11550, we need to divide everything from asset to human resources, including to the existing loans of the province.
Okay. But with the Mandanas ruling, have you done the math in terms of the benefits to Maguindanao that you are two provinces?
We have some or a little fear as regards the Mandanas ruling.
Okay, what is the fear?
As I said, we do the function of delivering the social services and the health services are not with us. So with the mandate of the Mandanas, we need to deliver on our own. So technically, much of our budget will go to the salaries and wages of our employees. That is one of our many fears as of now. Although we really voted for the division of Maguindanao because it's a long, long overdue dream of every Maguindanaoan.
Okay. Because just to go back to the Mandanas ruling, the issue last year was LGUs just got a total of 263 billion pesos, and no less than Governor Mandana said that wasn't the spirit of the law. For 2023, the allotment of the Department of Budget and Management is 962 billion pesos. I'm curious of that amount. Would you know or at least have an idea how much would go now that you're split into two? Because alangani naman, sir, the budget is still for one, and then you split it among yourselves. That wouldn't be the spirit of the Mandanas ruling anymore.
As far as I am concerned, ito yung pagkakaintindi ko. There is a fixed amount allocated for the whole provinces. Well, I mean, for all the entire 81 provinces throughout the country. That fixed amount is technically divided into 81. Now that we are already 82
by the
creation, by the creation of Maguindanao del Norte, so the fixed amount of the DBM will be divided into 82.
Yon.
So technically, the two of us will benefit out of the fixed amount.
Okay, that's
but
very.
As regards to the others, it's still based on the DBM guidelines.
Yeah, that's very good to know, sir. Well, I want to thank you, Attorney Cyrus Torreña, for joining me today. It's been quite informative. I do hope to speak with you again, sir.
Yeah, at any time, you can try to coordinate with me, and I am willing to answer any queries as far as Maguindanao is concerned. Thank you very much for your time.
All right, you take care, and good luck to everybody there.
Thank you, and good morning.